a simplified attempt of to understanding depression. Explaining depression to a one-year-old. Baby, depression feels like your mother not feeding you from her breasts anymore because she thinks you're too old. Only you don't think you're too old. You're confused and anxious. So you cry and yelp, but your mother doesn't listen. Your voice again gets lost somewhere in this universe. Second, explaining depression to a 16-year-old girl. Depression feels like small breasts, large waist, no thigh gap, like freckles on your face, like braces on your teeth. Depression feels like the guy who did not give a fuck about you because he thought you weren't fuckable enough. To the 20-year-old, depression feels like chewing onto your own voice. It feels like being in the wrong bed, being with the wrong person, being in the wrong body. Depression feels like disappointment. To the 35-year-old, depression feels like the body on the other side of the bed, coiled away from you. Depression feels like no love. Depression feels like repetitive sex positions. Depression sounds like the ticking of the alarm clock at 5 a.m. You brushing your teeth at 5:10. You wearing the tie by 6:10. You going to the office at 6:30, coming back home and having sex for precisely 7 minutes. To the 90-year-old, depression feels like the walls of the room trying to engulf you. Depression feels like the constant non-human presence inside your chest, which should actually be at your bedside. Depression feels like living to a 90-year-old when all he can think of is dying. For me, I often feel the fragrance of death rise from the center of my stomach to my chest to my windpipe, holding it tightly with a grip like a loved one trying to save someone standing at the edge of a cliff. The pessimism garden flowering inside my head and curling into no fucks given and yet withered leaves. People nudge at me and tell me that it's going to be fine, and I want to tell them that I have tried being fine, but I cannot be fine with my stuttering knees, with my stuttering legs, with my shaking hands, with a constant voice pounding inside my head. They tell me that positivity will heal me, but positivity can only absorb, it cannot nourish, and positivity will be brimmed to blackness. Positivity will not be able to nourish me, so I try to push away the people who try to linger too close. There are people who try to bandage the outlets, who try to put ointments, so I shut them away. Because the lurking hands somehow pain more than the scars, because the scars now run through my skin, run through my blood. Unlike me, my depression has a friend. She is called Insomnia. She wears black clothes. I and Insomnia on nights talk to the night sky. We talk to the moon. We have endless conversations. And we scrape landscapes across the night sky. My depression is in a lot of ways like my mother. It does not give up. It keeps repeating the same thing over and over again. Like, go to the bathroom, go to the bathroom, go to the bathroom. Pick the blade, pick the blade, pick the blade. Cut yourself, cut yourself, cut yourself. So you will often find redness whirlpooling with the water on the white tile of my bathroom floor. This is depression. Nothing fancy, only it takes away everything that you can ever fancy. Thank you.